WWA Archives.
Introducing team number one, the Big Kahuna. Sir Oliver Humperdinck presents, all from the island of Samoa, first at a total combined weight of 595 pounds, the Samoan SWAT team. And their partner, weighing 288 pounds, the Samoan Savage.
Three big wild men. This will be a street fight, Michael Hayes, in my opinion.
Be a great tune-up for him, then, because the Road Warriors have got the skyscrapers in the Chicago streetlight.
We'll hear Eric Capetta's introduction of the Road Warriors and Dr. Death momentarily.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents. First, from Oklahoma, weighing 287 pounds, Dr. Death. By manager Precious Paul Ellering from Chicago, Illinois. Total combined weight 585 pounds. The Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors.
This is like somebody walking through a house full of explosive, smoking a cigarette. You know, any minute something's going to blow the roof completely off.
Sitting on a powder keg giving off sparks, Jim Ross. But I tell you what, you talk about bad to the bone, if the song was ever more apropos. But I've got to wonder, and if we could get a close-up of Hawk's face, how he felt coming down that aisle. Remember the last time he did in Marietta, Georgia, he left her on a stretcher. Thanks to the guys in the ring, and of course, me, Bam Bam, and Jimmy Jam.
Well, I know you had great recall, you never forget that. I'm sure the Road Warriors won either. But right here we have the three giant Samoans who I am very impressed with. He should work for Foster Grant. Dr. Death starting out against the Samoan Savage. We saw these two men at the Clash of Champions, and they had one heck of a contest. And they're starting it out right here. Two big men, very quick and very talented. He missed with a clothesline. Dr. Death's got him up. Remember, this guy's 288.
Look at this, and he's got him up in a full press slam.
Tremendous strength exhibited by Dr. Death Steve Williams, who is training hard day and night for his match with Lex Luger at WrestleWar, when he will try to win the U.S. Championship from the total package.
I'm going to tell you, on that note alone, whoa, when mass meets mass.
Boom! Good counter move. That's a great counter move by the Samoan Savage, but he missed the elbow.
Look at these big men moving like this. What I was going to say is I'm going to go out on a limb here and predict that Dr. Death will beat Lex Luger because he's long overdue for a major title. It's been almost, what, a year and a half, 2 years now? And as you know, he's very well capable of it. Luger seems to have his sights not so much defending his title, but going after flares.
If Luger doesn't outthink him, power slam. Then Dr. Death matches up very favorably with the total package. One of the few men in the business that can't. But Luger is a very astute man. We know he'll have a great game plan. As Fatu goes to the far side. Good leapfrog by the Animal. Both these men at 300 pound range. And there is that power slam that shakes the Raptors. Samu comes in.
What's this?
Uh-oh, up with no great agility. And a double clothesline.
Well, I'm going to tell you that. That is agility. That is power. Whether you like them, which I don't, or whether you do, which you do, you've got to respect a move like that.
Hawk coming right off the top. Big chops, good Lord. And he hasn't forgot what the Samoans have, their altercations they have had. They're no friends. There's no doubt about that. Right there, but he's got a hard hit.
Oh, did not hurt the Samoan whatsoever. Hawk went to gloat. Surprised me that Hawk was only the third man in the ring. Seemed like after what happened, he'd have been the first one.
There's a neck breaker by Hawk. Good deep neck breaker. Samu in trouble. Boy, this is full of high impact. Precious Paul Ellery certainly got his game face on out there.
Oh, whoa.
Got a reversal. And Hawk nailed the kidney. The Savage. The street fighter from Chicago, though, is... You can't beat three guys. I don't care who you are.
Well, some people can.
Not these three, Mike. Not these three Samoans.
Well, I'm going to tell you, back in Samoa, Coleman said, The people there cherish them and love them for what they've done for their nationality. And you dang sure don't want to be caught up like this.
And that's like making a wish at Thanksgiving, pulling that turkey leg, whip that pulley bone, breastbone, I don't know.
But what comes to my mind here, thinking about a Chicago street fight, look at the pounding that's going on in this match. In the street fight, they'll be dressed with anything they want and bring anything they want.
And the Road Warriors have never lost, as we have found out, a Chicago street fight. Lateral press, well, 2.5 hours, so close. So close. Being punished. And we saw earlier Ricky Morton take a great deal of punishment, but he was able to make the tag. I would say that right now, Hawk, is in that prediction as well, Michael.
Oh, he definitely is. Probably the only difference here is Ricky Morton is one that not can so much take more punishment, but in a little better cardio. Hawk is a muscle man and maybe the strongest of all in the NWA. But cardiovascular is not his main forte. But look at him, as I say that, look at him come back.
Boy, these guys are reaching down. They are focused. Their collision with the skyscrapers is going to be a very earth-shattering experience.
The dive.
Speaking of earth-shattering, right there. Oh, right
there.
That's
it. That's it.
Oh, he's ticking.
Hey! All right, now wait a minute. Now, fair is fair. If that had been when the Samoans making a save, they'd have DQ'd it. He was just beaten pinned.
Man, this melee is broken out here. Remember, Hawk, I think, is the legal guy in the ring, but Animal being hammered now. Dr. Death outside with Samu. Miscalculation by Fatu, and from behind, the clothesline from behind on Fatu. Hawk's got him down. 1, 2, and 3.
Now, wait a minute.
The winners of the
match. Shoulder was up.
The team of Dr. Death, Steve Williams, and the Road Warriors.
Dr. Death being mugged on the outside here, and here comes the skyscraper. The skyscraper.
You know it was going to happen. You know it was going to happen.
The sky. Five, he's just clotheslined Paul Ellery. Mean Mark Hamrick on Hawk. The skyscraper saw the opportunity when the men were, they were tired. They had been in a heck of a match. They're going to try to really hurt him right here.
Teddy Long is so intelligent at doing this. Pay-per-view, pay-per-schmoo. Guys cannot wait. You can't tell a guy in a month you'll get your match. Animals want to go at it right now.
Fans, I don't want to see any more of this.
I do.
Well, I'm not.